again. And I'm better to use the biggest brush that you can get away with. Again, this being for reasons of deletion if you make a mistake. I like little minor imperfections. I have my reasons for it. The biggest one is, nothing's perfect in life, and I don't like totally symmetrical forces. Everything changes. Personally, I don't like perfectly drawn. To me, that's the perfect manicured course. I do like to keep myself at least a foot with heavy rough going into a bunker. That's my style, that's what I do. I try to keep it fair. Thank you. like the skeleton you get sometimes. The main down like rough. Hold the heavy rough, especially when you taste had an idea and a good method of doing it. Lay your light rough first, and then keep the heavy rough away from the light rough with a small bead. And they tend to eliminate the scalloping of light rough. Sometimes it doesn't happen. So instead, you can have a little bit of scalloping. Depends on where the scalloping is happening. I usually won't start planting trees till the very end, after I've already got all my holes laid on. I'm just trying to work on them, modifying them, that the trees get in the way, the shadowing gets in the way, you can't really tell what you have going on for this. Tedious as this is, while I'm doing it, I'm still thinking about the force that's coming down the pipe. What to add later, what I want to see. So, I really don't like the tediousness of it. Because of the brush back there, I will increase the heavy rough, because I really don't want the ball to just roll into the heavy brush. It's a pain in the butt. So if I can give myself probably a yard or so of heavy rough, then I'll stop the ball from going too far deep in. Hill. but maybe it's what it is. Here, so keep in mind that this area doesn't work in play, so having a wide cut of deep rough through here isn't necessary. Just have to break it up. But if it does, you can always add it. I'm lazy, and I don't want to have to do it. Besides, it doesn't count as on my object count if it's auto gen. The other good thing about getting distance markers, you do have a point of reference, so you know exactly or clocking out what you are off from the tee without having to look over on the menu that sits up there and tells you you're off this far from the tee. But it does give you a vector line to the tee. Yeah, it might say, okay, according to this right now, if you go up, it says, 241 to the pin, 300 from the tee, 320. But this line here, I know this is coming off in the center point of my original spot for the tee shot, which is 265. So now I have a point of reference. So if you were hitting straight into the green, I have this line, or this line. I trust the yellow vector line more than I trust this line. This line goes to the center of the green. This line is probably going to be going towards, to where I want to have a pin, most likely. And after a brief delay, I had a visit from my daughter. She's not little anymore. Still my daughter. Pretty sharp little cookie. Pretty proud. She's come over looking for a little bit of money. I guess that's how it goes. If I have it, I give it. Donald Trump, I am not by a long shot. But I'm not exactly hurting. Give to my kids to make sure they have what they need. Always been a firm believer that what you do in life will always come back in the fall. So if I have it and I see someone that needs it, I do. When I can. now if it looks like you're just hanging on the street not willing to do anything else, I'm not going to give it to you every film I see. But on that same token, if they're really down and out, I don't hesitate to give them a $5 bill. Or I'll go in and I'll buy them a hamburger and fries and cokes if they look like they really just spend the money on drugs. I can be an asshole. So we've almost finally come to the finish line here, getting around the fairway. All 450 some odd yards of it. As this sits up right now, it looks like it's going to be a 469-yard hole. From the center of the tee box to the center. Now, for the other parts of my little craziness, I like to see my first cut. I like to keep it semi-flat, 10 degrees, maybe of the most angle. Now, my school of thought on this is, if you're riding mower, how steep of an angle would you really feel comfortable taking it off while you're sitting on a tilt? If it doesn't look like you'd want to do it, then it's too steep of an angle. That's my take on it. I'm not going to get into major discussions on the exactness of what's safe and what's not safe. This is what I believe. And it's how I design. It's the most realistic as far as I'm concerned. And I'm sure some of the top designers out there will go well along with me on this one. There's always exceptions to the rules. I just don't think it's fair to have the ball run off a fairway and then go into a long run off over a cliff or a hill. Again, that's me. Others think differently. That's fine. Now I'm using the leveling, the flattening tool, as you say, but I've set a depth. Sometimes that's good, sometimes it's not so good. This time it didn't work on it, it didn't work out the way I wanted. Being an OCD probably isn't the greatest thing. I might not be OCD, I just goof around with it most of the time. I am a perfectionist though. Taking the idea, if you're going to do something, spend the time, it's worth spending the time doing it like the first time. Of course, I always have a second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth time, seventh time, and I still mess things up. But I try to do it the first time. If I can get it on the first pass, it's pretty amazing. Always about the views. Doesn't have to be perfect. Terrain doesn't have to be perfectly smooth. There's always going to be a little undulation. You can go through the dang bulldozer or a leveler or a grader and smooth everything out perfectly. It doesn't happen. Here we go, quick. The mantle's always rising and lowering on different fault lines. Who knows that I don't have a fault line? It's nobody's fault but mine anyway. So much for my legs up. So let's give this a look, seat down. This little area is going to need some help. Oh, that's good. Not a bad thing. It's just a thing. Alright, let's take a look. I think I have a decent hole in here. And I don't like doing anything crazy. I want that pin person. And because I said that, I've already thought about multiple days. The first day, it should be real tough. I do like the idea of tucking a pin back up in here. I really do. That could be a good day four. Since I'm starting front middle back, day one will be front, day two will be middle, day three back, and then day four will be front again. So, back up in here would be a perfect day four day. But just to start the round off, get out of here kind of good. because that's coming in pretty steep. Borderline front to middle. Yes, thank you. And over here. Touch-up. Let's do a flat first.
Rammy!